Mountain King for the 2600. This guy's got a good jump on him. I love the animation of this guy. Look at how high he can go. So you're collecting these diamonds. I believe they're diamonds. It's a little tricky to do that. You gotta start from way back. Oh, I blew it. Let's see if I can do it right here. You gotta go diagonal immediately, but you gotta not bump your head. So his... Oops, I did it again. Maybe right here. You can do that, but it's just really hard. God dang it. I'll try it one more time. Nope. Anyway, but the back line or the plot to this is actually pretty involved, or what you're supposed to do. You've got to find a thing and bring it up to a thing at the top. And it's like there's a crown and a flame and items. And I did read on Wikipedia the instructions how to play this game. And yeah, like I said, it's involved. It's a very cool game. And it's got extra memory. It's a RAM Plus type of cartridge. And so it's got music. It plays a wonderful symphonic version of Grieg's Hall of the Mountain King. And that will play when you get... So what you want to get is 1,025 points. Nice jump from collecting these diamonds. And then once you have that, you search for this item. I forget if it's a crown or a flame or something, and take it to the top. Ooh, it gets back up. So there's a timer. So those red lines represent... Okay. So I'm at 1,025. Now I want to search for this thing and take it to the top. You guys ever noticed the Atari sound chip is slightly out of pitch? There it is. See that crown? Right there. Let's see if I don't kill myself by... I'm going to try and go this way. But I'm going to compare this to Hero for the... why does it keep falling? Uh-oh. Something's wrong. For the ColecoVision, and Pickaxe Pete for the... He won't go that way. Uh-oh. Guys that play this, you're watching me do this wrong. I apologize if it's frustrating if you know how to play this game. I just got this cartridge a few weeks ago. I'm loving it. And it reminded me so much of Pickaxe Pete. Also Jumpman Jr., you know, and they all came out about the same time, like 83... 81, 82. I can't get... I'm gonna have to try something here. What if I go like this? Okay. And the music cues you into that you're going the right way. So it won't let me go over there. You got that cool little flashlight. So the music gives you a clue. Music stops, so I'm tempted to go down further even though the music stopped. No. But this is Mountain King. And it's cool because, you know, you're going to keep coming back to it just to figure it out, like me. You know. But you'll see how Pickaxe Pete has a similar looking guy. He's got like a long torso and these little cool little duder legs and duder arms. And the cool thing about the Pickaxe Pete is he can duck and go underneath these boulders that come at it. Pickaxe Pete is actually a more action-packed game than this. He's got boulders and picks and keys and stuff flying around, so all of you Odyssey haters, you're gonna be impressed. If you're going to be honest, it is a truly cool game. Atari gets a lot of kudos, and Odyssey always gets kind of bitch slapped for being like the redheaded stepchild of the 8-bit systems. But it actually sold as many units as the ColecoVision, around 3 million. So the second largest market for the Odyssey 2 was... We're talking Odyssey 2, not the old Odyssey. Not the Pong one, the cartridge one. The second largest market was Brazil. So you'll see a lot of Brazilian Odyssey, and they just call it Odyssey in Brazil, Philips Odyssey. Just to add to the confusion. But and the UK and Europe were big markets for the Odyssey 2. Owned by Philips, a worldwide corporation. That's, you know, your main reason why. Philips is a huge organization to this day. You know, they make TVs and washers and dryers and whatever. So, I give you a little... Uh-oh, music stopped, so I don't want to be down there. I'll give you a little or a lot, if depending on your attention span here, of Mountain King. And let's look at Hero, where you get to fly around with a little helicopter pack. All right, Hero, the helicopter emergency rescue operation game for the ColecoVision by Activision. Pretty sweet. And I just got this yesterday. And thanks to the guy I bought it from, I can't remember his name right now. Aaron, thank you. And so I'm loving this game. Once I get it started. Little helicopter pack. It's got a cool little, let me show you this. The box is over there. Never mind, I was going to show you the little comic book that comes with, on the box, there's like a little comic strip story. It's very cool. So you drop the bomb, and then you go back down, and you can shoot these spiders in the way, and you rescue this little duder down here. So you're saving your fellow miners. Get a little level up there. But so you gotta, you know, run away once you set that detonator off and move away so you don't get nothing down there. And I knew that. I should have remembered that from yesterday. So it's kind of cool how you do that. Set a little bomb up. And... and there he is. Wonderful graphics. You know, good looking ColecoVision graphics. The guy is cool. He's got a little helmet. His little helicopter pack. And the action, the gameplay is really smooth. I've only played this game for, 12 hours. I've only had it for the last 12 hours. Of course, I went to sleep, so I've only played it for less than an hour, really. But I've been watching it on YouTube and thinking, I need to get that game. Whoa, it didn't go there. It took 2 bombs. Interesting. And, so, I'm a newbie to this game as well. I'm an Odyssey 2 kid. So I think I'm important to the forum of Atari and ColecoVision and Intellivision people because of that. I'm the rarest breed of all of you guys. The least amount of people had the Odyssey 2. So I have a page too if you want to check it out. It's just Magnavox Odyssey 2, and then there's a group attached to it called Odyssey 2 Fans. And you're more than welcome to be a part of that. There's a multi-cart and all kinds of things for the Odyssey 2, so... I play games off the multi-cart. I've got one of those. The voice module is fantastic. And I just got fried. I kind of knew that was going to happen. I'm not sure how to get past that without dying yet. And, so this game's going to bring
years of fun. Oh, look at that. There's a snake down there. Oh. Ah, damn it. Got him. Uh-oh. Well, it's got rapid fire, actually. Just hold the button down. Now, I use the roller controller with the joystick, but I mount the controller for the ColecoVision into the roller controller so I can use those roller controller fire buttons. I just like those much better than the side buttons. Not that I can play any better. Oh, come on. Game over. So yeah, there's Hero and Mountain King, and now let's check out Pickaxe Pete for the Odyssey 2. So a funny story about Pickaxe Pete from when I was a kid. So we used to call it Kick-Ass Pete because my one buddy mistakenly thought that that was the name, Kick-Ass Pete. So one day he's all, "Hey, let's go play some Kick-Ass Pete." And we were like, "What?" And we laughed. So we used to call it Kick-Ass Pete. Oh, so Kick-Ass Pete, what you want to do is, he starts with a pick. He can jump with a pick. He can jump standing still. He can do this stomach dive to go underneath boulders. Of course, when you have a pick, you don't have to worry about the boulders. But the pick disappears, and you've got to be good at your jumping. So Pete's animation is fantastic. And he goes up these ladders very adeptly. To get to the next level, you want to get a key. See that key? You grab the key, now he flashes. And you can go inside of one of these squares in the middle when you get a chance. And those squares are the mineshaft elevators. Uh-oh, and I went into it. Whatever color it is what color the next mine is. So this one is black, which means you can't see the line. So you're in the dark. There's also these physics-defying boulders that will bounce up through the shafts, and they're really lethal. And they're hard to avoid, and you're going to have to use your duck and roll this maneuver to get around them sometimes. Uh-oh, I fell down. Now you got to wait for the ladders to come up. See, they go... Uh-oh. Sequential. The ladders come up each level. I don't know if that makes sense, but when you have a pick, ladders keep appearing on the same level until you grab one. See how there's ladders? You can jump for them. But when you lose your pick, the ladders stop appearing on that level. So as you can tell, I know this game better than the other two, seeing that I grew up with Kick-Ass Pete. I love Mountain King, and I'm loving Hero. You know, they're cool. And Jumpman Jr. is another one of my favorite lattice work, jump around and avoid stuff games, but Pickaxe Pete is killer, and like a lot of Odyssey games, it just kind of gets overlooked. But it's fun because there's a lot of action going on. But there's some strategies, like the one I'm working right now, where I'm waiting for that key. So basically, when the boulders collide, it'll either make a pick, picks fall to the bottom, like that, and keys come to the top. So, both are handy. But you need that key, and see the key's on the other side, so it's really dangerous to get near those mineshaft doors, so I'm gonna wait it out, and there you go. Timing is everything. You grab that key. Now, see, the door is red. That's a good color. So my next... It's got the cool little cutscene, too, where he's falling through the shaft. Fantastic. Just a lovely Odyssey 2 title. Pickaxe Pete. One of the Ed Averett games. Those of you that know the O2 heads out here know who... Ed Averett made 20 or 30 games for the Odyssey 2. Maybe like 25. He was one of the main authors of probably the best games. But they started to get third-party games. You can get Popeye. There's a bunch of homebrews like Lunar Lander, Planet Lander, I mean. Aliens Attacking. Mr. Roboto. There's a lot of cool games that were made by homebrew folks, and then third parties. There's Spider-Man from Parker Brothers. And very similar to the Atari one. But Pete, when his arms are up, that tells you he's going to jump. Like, if his arms are this way, he's going to jump that way. If his arm is that way, he's going to jump that way. And like I said, he can jump that, like that. And he can do the ducking thing. Uh-oh, I got it. So there's a little pickaxe, Pete. I think my high score is in the 800s, and that's pretty good as far as I've seen. But I wanted to compare these three games and just give you an idea of what was going on when I was a kid in the 80s, like a lot of you. But, yeah, check out my Magnavox Odyssey 2 page. There's also another one, my buddy Sean Hankey has one. It's, I think, the Magnavox and Philips Odyssey 2. He's got a really nice page. A lot of buy, sell, and swap guys on there. And he's got quite a few members. And he's always cool and he likes my videos and stuff. But, I've got a nice gathering of folks as well. They usually are subscribed to both. But, and then check out the group, Odyssey 2 Fans, and I think Sean's got a group too. But you guys be safe out there. This is great stay-at-home, shut-down, pandemic activity, you know. It's pretty hard to catch a virus playing a video game. Let's hope! If that comes next, damn it, I'm washed up. I'm cooked. I want a key, I want a key. He gets caught in those doors. Ooh, I'm lucky, look at that, I'm still alive. Pete. Kick-ass Pete. Look at that little walk. Alright, see you later.